So friends, welcome back to my classroom, and I am Professor G.N. Purohit from the Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, College of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, Rajasthan, India. And today we discuss something about the infectious causes of infertility and abortions in cattle. The specific causes of infertility include the bacteria, viruses, protozoa, and fungi. The bacteria may include brucella, campylobacter, leptospira, listeria, and viruses usually include IBR, BVD. The protozoal causes of infertility and abortion in dairy cattle include Tritrachomonas fetus, Neospora caninum, and Toxoplasma. Fungi such as Aspergillus could be a cause of abortion in dairy cows. Now, we talk of the venereal diseases. Venereal diseases are those diseases which are transmitted by the act of coitus, and venereal disease in cattle can be caused by bacteria, viruses, and protozoal organisms. Campylobacter fetus and Tritrachomonas fetus are the most common causes of venereal disease in dairy cattle. And this list also includes the bovine herpes virus, a form of IBR, Haemophilus somnus, ureaplasma, mycoplasma, and bovine virus diarrhea. As I said earlier, venereal diseases are those which are spread by the act of coitus. The major venereal diseases of cattle are campylobacteriosis and trichomoniasis. Trichomonas and campylobacter infection can cause early embryonic death or first trimester abortions. Young bulls usually clear the organisms quite rapidly but become reinfected upon breeding a cow that is carrying an infection. Once the organisms are present in the herd, they can be passed from cow to cow by the herd bulls or by contaminated breeding equipment. Older bulls, 4 to 5 years and above, are more chronically infected. So it's an insidious disease in which the bull is an asymptomatic carrier. So first we talk about trichomoniasis. Trichomoniasis is caused by a mobile, complex, three-haired, single-cell protozoan called Tritrachomonas fetus. The organism survives in microscopic folds of the skin that line the bull's penis and the internal sheath. There is a worldwide prevalence of this disease. This disease causes sterility, abortion, and pyometra. Here is a Trichomonas organism. It's a three-haired flagellate organism, which is highly motile. The transmission of trichomoniasis is from cow to cow by the bull, nearly always a disease of cattle who are naturally bred. It's transmitted by sexual contact with an infected mate. Rare cases of transmission through artificial inseminations are on record. You see, Trichomonas can survive minus 196 degrees centigrade, and so the bulls must be tested for trichomoniasis. The clinical signs in cows include repeat breeding, abortion in the first half of gestation, and post-service pyometra. The cow does not appear ill sometimes and is infected during breeding. The cow may show a subtle mild vaginal discharge 1 to 3 weeks after a mating. Protozoa attach to the lining of the reproductive tract. An inflammatory response occurs, resulting in the death of the embryo and hence repeated breedings. Trichomoniasis in the bull. There are no signs. Semen quality and sexual behavior are not affected. The trichomonas Monads live in the crypts inside the sheath of the bull's penis. Since the crypts are deeper in the older bulls, so they reside more frequently in the older bulls. As the bull ages, the skin grows, folds increase in the penis and sheath, creating additional pockets for the organism to thrive. Older bulls over 3 years of age are more likely to become chronically infected than younger bulls. A bull usually becomes a lifetime carrier, and it's best to test after 2 weeks of sexual rest. The diagnosis, sometimes the organisms can be recovered under a microscope from the discharges, the pus-like discharges that the animal expels after a mating. Then we can culture the organism for 1 to 7 days. Even if one bull is positive, you have to assume that the herd has been exposed to trichomoniasis. The cows usually clear the infection rapidly, and they must be tested after embryonic death or pyometra. There usually is a history of a new bull introduction in the herd, after which the disease is spread. Direct smear examination of the abomasal contents of the aborted fetus and wet smear examination of the vaginal discharge of prepucial washings can be performed. The organism can be cultured in diamonds or Tobey's media transported at 4 degrees centigrade. A test to test the presence of trichomonas is the vaginal mucus agglutination test. Then virgin heifer test mating can be performed to test the bulls if they are infected. Here's a picture showing how we can collect the prepucial washings. The prepucial washings can be collected from the bulls. Normal saline or ringer lactate is infused in the penis, then it's massaged, and the collected fluid is then concentrated and the trichomonas can be visualized under a microscope. Prevention and control. It is easier to prevent the infection than to try to control it after it enters the herd. Avoid contact of uninfected cattle to other cows and new bulls. For infected cows, a sexual rest of 8 to 12 weeks would take care of the trichomonas. Avoid renting or leasing bulls. Replace cow bulls with young bulls. It's advisable to use artificial insemination for breeding. The infected animals can be treated with imidazole derivatives, sodium iodide, and the local application in the bulls. A vaccine is available which can be used. This is a vaccine, Trichomonas fetus vaccine, available commercially, and it can be used before the breeding season. Then a second insidious disease, campylobacteriosis, is caused by Campylobacter fetus, a gram-negative bacteria affecting cattle, buffalo, sheep, and goats. The disease is venereal in cattle and is characterized by early embryonic deaths, increased services per conception, and abortions at 4 to 6 months. The causes of infertility and abortion include Campylobacter fetus, subspecies venerealis, or the subspecies fetus. The Campylobacter survives in moist environments for weeks to months. Some strains tolerate cold. They remain viable in feces, milk, water, vaginal discharges, and poultry litter. The clinical signs include infertility, early embryonic deaths, but the abortions are uncommon. The male is an asymptomatic carrier in this disease. Adult bulls are more affected and may carry infection for long times. Sheep aborting 1 year are resistant the next year. Bovine genital campylobacteriosis can be diagnosed by history of increased services per conception, repeat breeding, and organism identification in samples is difficult. Clarks or diamonds media must be used. Then vaginal mucus agglutination test, virgin heifer test mating, or fluorescent antibody test can be used for the diagnosis. Detection of IgA A. In cervical mucus, ELISA, and culture of the organisms can be attempted. The prepucial washings and vaginal cultures can be sent to the lab for the organism identification. The bulls may be treated and cows usually are not treated. Widespread use of artificial insemination has limited this disease, wherever artificial insemination is the only means of breeding. This disease has vanished because of addition of antibiotics in the seminal diluter, which kills the organism. A vaccine is available. One must avoid renting or leasing bulls and replace cull bulls with young bulls. All new bulls must be tested. Campylobacter species is susceptible to 1% sodium hypochlorite, 70% ethanol, 2% glutaraldehyde, and iodine-based disinfectants, phenolic disinfectant, formaldehyde, moist or dry heat, gamma irradiation, and UV radiation. So, disinfection can be easily performed at the farm premises. Now we discuss about one more important contagious and zoonotic disease, brucellosis. It's also known as andulan fever, and it's also known by the name contagious abortion and Banks disease. This is a zoonotic bacterial disease affecting cows, buffaloes, goats, sheep, horses, and dogs, causing late gestation abortions in cattle and orchitis in bulls, many times seen in the form of outbreaks. The organism Brucella abortus is an intracellular gram-negative coccobacillus. It's a facultative intracellular pathogen and has 9 biovars. Additional Brucella that affect cattle besides Brucella abortus include Brucella melitensis and Brucella suis. The organism can persist in the environment. The population at risk include, the disease is an occupational disease, cattle ranchers, dairy farmers, veterinarians, abattoir workers, meat inspectors and lab workers, hunters, travelers and consumers consuming unpasteurized dairy products are at risk of developing this zoonotic disease. The disease is of worldwide distribution. It has been eradicated in some countries and notifiable. It's considered a notifiable disease in many countries. The World Health Organization for Animal Health says that poor surveillance and reporting due to lack of recognition has not eradicated the disease in some areas. The mode of infection for brucellosis is ingestion of contaminated pasture, water, licking the aborted fetuses. The organisms are shed in milk and uterine discharges. The uterus of pregnant cows get infected from blood. The erythritol sugar in the uterus is a good medium for the growth of Brucella. After abortion and uterine involution, organisms colonize the udder. In cows, the disease is seen as abortion, stillbirths, birth of weak cows, retained placenta, decreased lactation, and in the bulls, there is appearance of epididymitis, orchitis, infertility, and arthritis. The laboratory diagnosis of brucellosis includes direct examination, serology, Brucella antigen test, complement fixation, ELISA, and others, milk testing, culture and identification, and PCR techniques. Stain smears from aborted material stained with Coster and Jean Nelson method can reveal the organisms. Organisms can be cultured from fetal stomach placenta, which has a Moroccan leather appearance. There are some ELISA tests which can detect the presence of Brucella. Serological tests include Rose Bengal test, CFT, FAT, milk ring test. The Rose Bengal plate test can be used as an initial screening test on semen samples. All positive samples are re-examined using the serum agglutination test or the CFT. Rose Bengal negative samples are not normally tested. A serum agglutination test is very widely used but detects non-specific antibodies as well as specific antibodies from brucella infection and vaccination. The CFT is a more definitive test than the SAT, especially in differentiating titers arising from infection or from vaccination. The MRT milk ring test, which detects brucella antibodies in milk, is very useful in screening the presence of brucellosis in herds by collecting bulk milk samples or in individual animals. Positive results can then be followed by using other diagnostic tests or on individual animals. The postmortem lesions include granulomatous matous inflammatory lesions in the reproductive tract, udder, lymph nodes and joints. The placenta is abnormal, it's leathery, there is an enlarged liver, and the bulls may show swollen scrotum. The control, the widespread use of strain 19 vaccine for calf-foot vaccination of 4 to 8 months female calves has been practiced in many countries, but currently a RB51, which is a vaccine which can be used for adult cattle, is also available. The eradication of the disease include notification, isolation of aborting animals, disposal of aborted fetuses and placenta, and slaughter of the infected animals. Then genital mycoplasmosis or ureaplasmosis can cause infertility in dairy cattle. These two organisms are cell wall deficient organisms. Mycoplasma cause vulvovaginitis, and both these organisms can cause infertility and abortion. They are frequently isolated from semen and the transmission is through semen. Genital tuberculosis. It causes peritoneal adhesions of the uterus, presence of multiple nodules on the uterus, formation of abscesses, pinhead-sized granular lesions, and the presence of ovariobursal adhesions and thickened tortuous fallopian tubes is diagnostic of tuberculosis. The organism can be cultured and definitive diagnosis established. An animal showing a chronic vaginal discharge must be examined for acid fast organisms and must be suspected for genital tuberculosis. Leptospirosis, we talk of leptospira, is a zoonotic disease caused by parasitic spirochetes and characterized by fetal death, abortion and birth of weak cows. In acute form of the disease, there is increased body temperature, hemoglobinuria, abortion. In the chronic form of the disease, there is abortion after 6 months, birth of weak cows, development of mastitis, blood-tinged milk in all the 4 teeth, and disease is most common in September and October in some countries. The transmission is through mucous membrane and abraded skin. Diagnosis: antibodies in the fetal sera, urine sediments. The treatment includes streptomycin and a vaccine is available for the leptospira. For the control of leptospirosis, separate cattle from pigs, rodent must be controlled and water logging must be avoided. Listeriosis is caused by gram-positive coccobacilli. It's a sporadic disease of ruminants characterized by encephalitis, abortion during the last trimester, neonatal septicemia commonly occurring in winter. Transmission is by ingestion. Clinical signs include abortion, retained fetal membranes, endometritis, weight loss and transient infertility. The diagnosis is by fetal tissues and the therapy includes the administration of tetracyclines. The control include removal of the fetal tissues and avoiding feeding of spoiled feed to cattle. Salmonella abortions are sporadically caused by Salmonella dublin in cattle, Salmonella abortus ovis in sheep and Salmonella enteritis in pigs. However, the most important is Salmonella abortus equi, which causes abortion in mares. Salmonella are present in the environment and mares abort at 6 to 9 months and evidence slight fever. Another streptococcal infection which causes abortions in mares occurs in poorly managed farms. Then viral causes of infertility and abortion in cattle. infectious bovine rhinotracheitis, IBR, or rat nose, also known as infectious pustular vulvovaginitis, is caused by bovine herpes virus 1 that affects cattle and buffaloes. The respiratory form causes fever, congestion of nasal mucosa, nasal discharge, and ulcers on the nose and trachea. The conjunctival form affects all ages of animals and usually causes conjunctivitis. The abortive form causes abortion in the second half of gestation. There is red-colored fluid in the body tissues of the fetuses, aborted fetuses. And in the encephalitic form, the young cows are affected less than 6 months of age. Vulvovaginitis or coital vesicular exanthema has a venereal transmission and causes balanoposthitis in bulls and vulvovaginitis in cows with whitish discharge for 2 to 3 weeks. The transmission of IBR is contact with infected cattle. The organism identification can be done from vulvar vaginal scrapings, nasal conjunctival swabs. Samples should be refrigerated and sent on culture medium to the lab. Histopathology of the liver, fetal liver shows multifocal necrosis. The treatment is palliative. Infected animals are lifelong carriers. Heifers are immunized at 6 to 8 months with vaccines that are available. The immunity is 3 years and live vaccines often produce latent infection. The control include destruction of aborted material and movement restriction. Modified live vaccines and kill vaccines are available for pregnant animals. Bovine virus diarrhea is another viral cause of abortion and infertility in cattle. It's caused by a toga virus, which has two types, type 1 and type 2, which causes gastrointestinal disease and abortions. The transmission is through aerosol and contact with persistently infected animals. The bulls excrete virus in the semen following chronic infection. Cows born from infected animals are persistently infected and are known as the PI cows. The clinical signs include pyrexia, diarrhea, oculonasal discharge, ulcers and abortions at 2 to 4 months and mummification. The mucosal type of disease shows diarrhea and nasal discharge. A history of diarrhea and immunohistochemistry on fetal tissues can help in the diagnosis, including tests like PCR and ELISA. The control requires strict isolation and removal of persistently infected animals. Vaccination of replacement heifers with the modified live vaccine 2 months before first breeding is suggested, and kill vaccines are suggested for other animals. Then chlamydiosis is most common cause of abortion in sheep and goats and rarely cattle, caused by chlamydia cittasi, which is a gram-negative intracellular organisms which have both DNA and RNA. The transmission is through pigeons, sparrows, our reservoirs, ticks and insects help in transmission. The organism persists in feces of infected animals and is shed in uterine discharges for 3 weeks post-abortion. The clinical signs include abortion during last month in primipara sieves, slight febrile reaction and blood tinge discharge. Placentitis is common. The diagnosis, necrotic changes in the placenta are observed. Microscopic examination of Jean Nelson stain smears from the placenta or fetal tissue are suggested. A vaccine, Anzovac, which is administered intramuscular or subcutaneous 8 weeks prior to breeding in sheep is suggested. The immunity lasts for 3 years. Chlamydia can affect human beings, so be careful. Neosporosis is a protozoan infection affecting cattle and rarely sheep and goat. It's acquired by ingestion of feed contaminated with feces of dogs and characterized by abortion between 4 to 6 months of gestation and birth of congenitally infected heifers. The clinical signs include abortion when animals are stressed. No other signs are evident. White foci in the muscles, heart, liver of the fetuses can help in the diagnosis. Besides that, PCR, fluorescent antibody test, and ELISA are available. Zootic abortion is a cause of abortion and premature calving in cattle grazing in California, Nevada, and Oregon of the USA. The disease is caused by unnamed bacteria, a gram-negative bacteria of Myxobacterium family. The transmission is by an ergastic tick. The clinical signs include sporadic or outbreaks in the last trimester, mostly in the heifers. Typical lesions on the fetus include petechiae on conjunctiva, tongue, oral mucosa, and these typical lesions can help in diagnosis. There is enlargement of prescapular lymph nodes and reduction of thymus with hemorrhages over it. For the control of the ticks in the area is suggested. Now we talk of mycotic abortions. Aspergillus fumigatus, a mucus species or candida species, are the sporadic cause of abortion and infertility in cattle and other animals like mare, sheep, goat and swine. Abortions are common in winter after a wet summer. Feeding of straw with fungi is the etiology. Rarely inhalation of spores can cause the infection. Abortions occur during 6 to 8 months in cattle. Placentitis with coffee bean or cup-shaped cotyledons is characteristic lesion of mycotic abortions. The microscopic examination of placental or skin lesions after treatment with 10% KOH reveals the fungi and their hyphae. Then non-infectious causes of abortion in cattle include ingestion of poisonous plants or administration of chemicals, plants with loco weeds, sweet clover, pine needle, can cause abortion in dairy cattle. The administration of pharmaceuticals like nitrates, xylazine, anthelmintics can cause abortions rarely. Hormonal deficiencies like that those of progesterone or accidental administration of hormones like estrogens, corticosteroids can result in abortion in dairy cattle. Nutritional deficiencies with such as those of vitamin A, E, iodine or selenium are known to cause abortion in dairy cattle. Severe stress like heat, cold, transport and trauma can result in abortion because of the release of stressors in these cattle causing the lysis of the cell. Accidental AI of pregnant animals and genetic defects of embryo can also result in abortion in dairy cattle. Now we talk of induced abortion or the veterinary termination of pregnancy. Abortions are sometimes desired to be induced in various farm animals. When they are induced nearer to parturition, they are called induced parturitions. The reasons for inducing abortions could be diseases of pregnancy like pregnancy toxemia in sheep and goats, where continuance of the pregnancy would further worsen the condition of the patient. Systemic diseases like hemoglobinuria in buffaloes often indicate the induction of abortion to reduce the load of the ailing patient. Abnormal pregnancies like hydrop, allantois, ventral hernia, rupture of the prepubic tendon, fetal mummification, and accidental gestation in yearling cattle can also indicate an induced abortion. Termination of accidental small-age pregnancies of heifers. Cattle and buffalo. Prostaglandins are the most suitable drugs for inducing abortion in cows. They are effective at all stages of gestation except during the 5 to 8 month period when they should be combined with corticosteroids to terminate the pregnancy. Estrogens and corticosteroids can be used to terminate the bovine pregnancy. In sheep and goat, prostaglandins and corticosteroids are effective, whereas in the sow, prostaglandins alone are effective in terminating pregnancy. Estrogens are ineffective in the sow as they are leutotropic in this species. So thank you very much for your patient hearing. Kindly share this video and subscribe to my channel GN Purohit at YouTube if you like them. Thank you very much.